मृत्यु सर्वहरश्चाहम् उद्भवश्च भविष्यताम् कीर्ति श्रीर्वाक्च नारीणाम् स्मृतिर्मेधा धृति क्षमा.
I am the all-consuming death and the origin of future beings of the feminine qualities kirti, fame, shri, prosperity, vak, speech, smriti, memory, medha, intelligence, dhriti, consistency, and kshama, forgiveness. So he first begins by saying, I am the all-consuming death and the origin of future beings, means the world consists of a constant chain of birth and death. He's not just talking about all of us being born and dying, but there is the annihilation of the past and the birth of the future. The present is the moment that joins the two. That's why you have what is known as Sandhya Vandana. Sandhya Vandana, where you repeat the Gayatri Mantra at dawn and dusk, the death of the night and the birth of the day. The meeting point of that is when it is considered auspicious to pray to Atman. Similarly, dusk. So it's the... Now when you learn to accept birth and death, both, then you reach this samam where you are in touch with Atman. Similarly, thoughts. A thought is born in your mind, and as the thought goes down, the next thought comes up. The meeting point of two thoughts, the death of the previous thought, the birth of the next thought, is where you are in touch with Atman, Brahman. But that moment is so short that you don't recognize it. So what you do is, you reduce the speed of thoughts that flow in your mind. When you get to a stage where the interval between the two thoughts is long enough for you to connect with Atman, and that is the moment of enlightenment. So, all-consuming death and birth of future beings. Of the feminine qualities, why he says feminine qualities is, first of all, grammatically all these seven are feminine, but also that the feminine is associated with being content with what is known. The masculine qualities are associated with exploration, with reaching out to the unknown and capturing the unknown, to have that the courage and conviction to explore into the unknown. This doesn't mean that only women have the feminine qualities or that only men have masculine qualities. Nowadays, it's getting to be the other way around. In the spiritual field, you need this tremendous courage and conviction to explore into unknown realms. So both men and women have. In spirituality, the rishis are talking to the minds, to the inner personality. They are not talking to the external form. So don't get mixed up there. So now, the seven goddesses seem to preside over the seven virtues. The seven virtues are kirti, fame. When you are unselfish, when you are dedicated to a higher cause, when you are contributing to society, to the world will automatically reward you with success, prosperity, fame, name, so on and so forth. Shri, prosperity. Prosperity is a byproduct of your adding value to the world. If you don't add value to the world, you may have everything else, you will never get prosperous. Prosperity might come to you once in a while, but then something will happen and again you'll be back to square one. So what will happen? Stock market will crash. Your investments will go bust. Something or the other happens to remove the prosperity from you. The way to gain permanent prosperity is through unselfishness. Vak, speech. As the Upanishad says, don't waste your time speaking on mundane, worldly things. If at all you speak, Speak something that is meaningful. Speak something that will benefit people. Don't sit gossiping all the time. And take a look at our thoughts, what we speak. Take an audit of what we speak from morning to evening. Especially your, now watch out, your cell phone conversations are all recorded. You know that, huh? So, go through that and see how much of it is trash. Fairly large percentage is trash. Okay, so you said it, not me. Smriti, memory. There are certain things that you need to remember, certain things you need to forget. All the insults that people have bestowed on you in the past, press the delete button on them. It's not worth remembering. Things that you need to remember are the higher values of life, knowledge, intelligence, medha. Spiritual path makes you extremely intelligent, means not just a gatherer of information, but have that intellectual sharpness to be able to go through all the confusions of life. You're never confused, you're never undecided, you're never bewildered. Dhriti, consistency. Consistency is one of the most important qualities that lead to success, both in the world and in the spiritual path. And kshama, forgiveness. What a wonderful quality that is. Kshama is nothing but understanding the limitations, the weaknesses of people. And when you understand that you also have weaknesses and how difficult it is to overcome even one weakness, you look at another person's weakness, you only feel compassion because he or she is also a fellow traveler on the journey of life. So who are you to pass judgment on anybody? Forgiveness. So this is the thing. Now death, that we were talking about, an interesting story is that Devaki, when she gave birth to Krishna, the baby, and Krishna was taken away from her very soon, she looks at Krishna and realizes that this is not no ordinary child, this is the divine that's come into life. And she looks at Krishna and says, as soon as a mortal is born, death is chasing after him. And he's afraid, he's insecure, and he does all sorts of things to escape death. He never manages that. But only that person who has the good fortune of seeking refuge with you, Krishna, escapes death, because death comes and has to quietly retreat from the feet of Krishna. And she's talking about the baby, the infant. So spiritual knowledge is a combination of poetry, of deep feelings of love, of admiration, and the truth, the bare truth. Next verse.